welcome to the second episode of Even Bananas. We're back to focus on our favourite fundamental friends, the neutrinos. There's a lot more to neutrinos than Wolfgang Pauli ever imagined when he first suggested they existed back in 1930. And before we dive into the details, I thought it would probably help to give you an overview of everything we've learned about neutrinos since then. And I bet you're wondering why this show is even called Even Bananas. We'll get to that as well. So today, I'm going to do possibly the hardest thing I've ever done in physics, explain neutrinos in under 60 seconds. Timer, please. Okay. Neutrinos are fundamental particles that can't be broken down into smaller pieces. They're the second most abundant particle in the universe, second only to photons, particles of light. Almost every time atomic nuclei come together or break apart, neutrinos are produced. And that means that almost everything produces neutrinos, including stars, the Earth, people, and yes, even bananas. Like delicious Neapolitan ice cream, neutrinos come in three flavors: electron, muon, and tau neutrino. And this is where it gets weird. Neutrinos can change types as they travel. It's called oscillation. It's something we didn't expect and still can't fully explain. Theory says that neutrinos don't have mass, but they do. Unfortunately, it's so small we haven't been able to measure it, which is great. Finally, neutrinos are pretty antisocial. They don't like to interact with other matter, which obviously makes them hard to study and means we have to build huge detectors to be able to do it. So why do we even bother? Well, neutrinos might explain why the universe exists and why there's no antimatter around. So if we want to understand the universe, we have to understand neutrinos. I did it. Now don't worry if you didn't catch all of that. We're going to go into all of these things in more depth later on. I'll introduce you to some of the amazing researchers and experiments trying to understand these particles. But for now, that's it for this episode. Tell us in the comments what you want to learn about neutrinos, and I'll see you soon.